Hi and welcome to another video. Today I want to show you something really cool that I want to do. I've got a VCR and I've got a computer and I want to create my own server. This will be a DIY job that everyone can do at home as long as you have a VCR. Not very easy to find, but you still can find them around. And a computer that obviously it will work inside, and that means size wise. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put the computer on the side. Actually, first I'm going to show you. This is just a Dell Optilex. Very simple, very small, which will work really well for this. I'm going to put it on the side, and I've got my VCR right here. This VCR I brought it from Portugal. So let's open up and see what we've got inside. This wasn't working anymore, so might as well do something useful with this. So for that, I'm going to unscrew everything. See the interior, remove everything from inside, and then I'm going to cut a piece of MDF where I'm going to attach motherboard to it. But you'll see everything that I'll do. So, VCR, and it's proper stuck. There you go. So we've got this, and this will go out of the loop. Wow, amazing. I wonder why this video wasn't working anymore. Could it be because of this? Yeah, a fork. My son, when he was young, he used to stick stuff everywhere. And this just shows exactly the sort of thing he used to do. So now let's see how I dismantle this. So I've got some screws here, so I've got some connectors. I'm going to get rid of the connectors and I get rid of the power cord. Like so. Oh, this is the aerial cord. Goodbye. So now we have some screws right here that I'm going to unscrew, and I'm just literally just taking a look and see. Whenever I see a screw, I just get rid of it. So, bear in mind one thing, before I actually attempted this, I saw the size of the computer and the size of the video, so it should fit. If it doesn't fit, I'm in big trouble. So, there you go. Another screw out of the way, and another one, quite a few. And this one here, and this one doesn't want to come out, there you go. So now I can see the front panel comes off. The front panel comes off, so obviously this I don't want to damage, so I'm just going to take it easy. Like so, because I want to retain the video as it looks. Ooh, this is very tricky. There we go. And another one, and another one. Just a couple of clips, and now I've got the front of the VCR. Cool, and I found some more screws. So let's get rid of these screws. The reason why I'm using this PC is because it's really small. It's an Intel i5 processor, quad core. It has 4GB RAM, but I think I've got some more RAM laying around that I might use it to upgrade a bit more. And I can basically, it's very simple to set up as well as I can get it inside with this. That only has a small fan for airflow. We're talking about a really, really small fan. And has the fan for the cooling system. Obviously, I'm going to change the thermal paste compound on the CPU and the cooler. And I'm going to make some vents in the video so I can actually have it running nice and cool. Okie dokie, so that's quite funky stuff here. and we're talking about, I don't know, this sort of thing. Yuck. So we are done in here. So this is the power button. So we've got the power button and the eject. It would be nice if I could reuse this to use it as a powered PC. Actually, I think I might be able to do it. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to disconnect this somehow. But it's not coming off, so I'll just try to pull it off without damaging the... Actually, I'm going to get some scissors. Better yet, I've got a nice knife that will cut this off. But there you go. So, this I want to retain for now to see if I can use it to power the PC. I think it will look really cool. So we've got a couple more screws in here. Just a matter of putting it. And this one's here. They have a plastic thing at the back. So I'm going to put these screws on the side so I can reuse them in case I need them. So there we go. So this is pretty much ready to come off. I've got some clips here. So I'll just go like so. So I'm going to try from the front. One clip, two clips, three clips, and there's another one there. And this should come out sometime today. There we go, and cool. So at this moment in time we only have a plastic case. My idea is measure this up like so and cut an MDF sheet. I'm going to cut 6mm because I don't want it to be too thick because obviously height issues that I make encounter, and I'm going to drill some holes, put some connections for the motherboard standoffs, and then take it from there. I'm going to just take a quick look at the PC. So I'm going to put this right here. So this is PC. So we've got the motherboard, IO shield, if the IO shield would be on this side, it would be amazing. So what I need to do is actually, on this side, I need to cut this off for the IO shield to go for the motherboard. And probably a bit of perspex in here and make some holes for ventilation. And for the power supply, actually, because I've got the power supply in there. So I think it's quite cool. We've got the small fan here. As you can see, it's really small. And it's just a basic computer, nothing special, nothing fancy. This had a DVD drive and a hard drive, no anymore. I'm going to connect two hard drives to it, and I'm going to connect it to my network, where everyone in their devices can upload, download files from it, and even stream files from it, so like home videos and whatever. So we are done for now. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, hit that bell button so you can see the next step of this build. And don't you think it will look cool? Personally, I do think so. By the way, I'm not sponsored by Vorten. Vorten is a Portuguese brand. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.